Starting a Business for Beginners and Dummies. Written by Giovanni Richters. Read by Daniel Riccio. You have probably read countless success stories about individuals starting businesses around the world. Their time and effort have been put to the test and resulted in something incredible, a lucrative business. If this is a goal that you also have in mind, you are taking the right step by using this book to guide you. With all of the wonderful ideas that you have been developing, it is finally time to be more proactive. You are going to learn exactly what it takes to start your own business. Not only will you understand what you need to do to get it up and running, but you will also discover many useful tips that will continue to help along the way. Whether you have the funding in place already or you are just starting out with an idea, you still need to go through all of the motions to turn your dream into a reality. Many people get ahead of themselves when it comes to starting a business because there are so many factors to take into consideration. You need that great idea and the funding to back it. But you also need something in abundance to truly get the business off the ground, a driving passion. Through reading this book, you will uncover where your passion lies. As you explore the different steps, you will fully understand how to stay motivated during this process. It is naturally going to come with its ups and downs, but part of being a business owner is riding the waves. When you are up, you want to continue doing the same things that brought you to this successful point. When you are down, you must brainstorm what you can do differently. Not only will this be a process for you to study and to become more educated on the topic of owning a business, but it will also be introspective. Through each milestone you reach, you will learn more about yourself. These are some of the highlights that you will learn from reading this book. How to develop your great idea. How to remain patient during each step of the way. Why there is a difference between an in-person shop and an e-commerce shop. What you can do to get real funding. How to build a wonderful team that will work hard for you. Each of these steps is essential if you want to create the best business that is fully functional and lucrative. Do not give up now, because you are just getting started. Through educating yourself, you are already one step closer to realizing that it is possible for you to join the ranks among other business owners who have already reached their goals. Chapter 1: Turning Your Idea into a Business. You want to start your own business. That's amazing. Every great successful business begins with an idea that takes off. As a business owner, you must be passionate about your idea no matter what. This is something that you are going to craft from the ground up, so you need to believe in it wholeheartedly. One of the biggest mistakes that business owners make is launching their business before they are fully ready to commit to their idea. With a lack of passion comes a lack of motivation to keep the business afloat. As you begin working with your idea, try to develop it into its final form before you rent out any office space or purchase that website domain name. This is going to make you feel like you are truly prepared for the work to come. Starting a business is not easy, but working on a business that you are unsure about is even harder. The idea must be developed for it to be successful. In this chapter, you will learn about many different ways to do so. No matter what type of stage you are on, remind yourself that you are eventually going to be successful. This type of positive manifestation is exactly what you need to turn your idea into a reality. Brainstorming. No matter how much thought you have put into your business plan so far, think about it some more. This is brainstorming, and it is going to lead you one step closer to success. To avoid having a premature launch, you need to think about all of the possibilities surrounding your business idea, your line of work, your niche, your market, and your approach. When you combine these factors, you will have a better idea of where you are in terms of being able to really get started in a fully functional way. Below are more factors to help you get started. Get inspired. When you look around, you should be able to see how your ideas will fit into the world. It needs to be clear to you how people will use your product or benefit from the service that you will provide them. By learning as much information as you can about your field, this is going to give you a necessary boost of inspiration. When you truly feel inspired by something, you should feel happy to put effort into it. Remind yourself that nobody is forcing you to complete this business. You are doing this because you truly want it to become a success. Consider your daily habits. Would you use your own product or service? This is an important question to ask yourself because it will tell you a lot about the functionality of your idea. If you can find a use for this in your daily life, then there is a chance that others will be able to do the same. The idea must be relatable enough to be useful to people, yet unique enough to create some type of incentive. There are several different brands of gum, so what makes you choose to purchase your favorite brand each time? These are the elements you must think about that occur on a daily basis. Troubleshoot issues. Everyone experiences hardship at some point throughout their days. Whether work is stressing you out or you need to buy new tires for your car, inconveniences are bound to happen to you. Instead of succumbing to these problems, you can use them to help you brainstorm for your future clients. Think about how you can fix your everyday problems. Much like the concept above, there are likely other people who experience the same hardships you do. Finding some type of relief is a very big incentive to purchase a product or to hire someone to perform a service. Branch off your original idea. With all of the above brainstorming being completed, think about your original idea again. See if you can evolve it into a more developed form. This may mean fine-tuning some of the working operations or how you plan on marketing yourself to your customers. No matter what it is, each small improvement will become a part of the bigger picture that is your final business plan. Even if you feel incredibly secure in your plan, see if there are any ways that you can work on it further. Patience is required. So many future business owners want to jump right into the action. This is a compelling strategy at first, but it becomes very discouraging when you are forced to shut down because you did not see the plan all the way through. Keep this enthusiasm and save it for when you have a well-developed and tested business plan. As a future business owner, you must balance your own personal desire for the business to thrive and your calculated risks. To get to this point, you need to test the waters before you dive right in. When you think realistically about your business, this leaves less room for disappointment. While we all want to turn our idea into a business that makes us six figures, this is an ambitious goal that most of us are unlikely to see through within the first year of business. Set attainable goals for yourself as a measure of setting yourself up for success instead of failure. This is going to boost your morale and show you that slow and steady wins the race. Test your idea. Once you know what your mission is and what your company will stand for, you need to test your idea. You can do this in many different ways. One of the easiest is to pitch it to your loved ones. While they do have a bias and will want to support you, they will also be able to let you know whether or not they can see a use for your product and service or their own daily lives. Taking this as a survey, you will see that this can become very useful information before you launch to the public. Another way to run a test is to get a group of beta testers involved. If you do not want to worry that your loved ones are too biased, you can seek out those who do not know you to give you their honest opinions. This process usually involves you giving the group your product or service for free, or even paying them to try it. In return, you get an honest opinion. While you may be hesitant to use any of your funding for this purpose, it is something that can tell you a lot about your future success. Your beta testers will give you a trial run of operating this business that you have been developing. By charting their response, you will be able to see a preview of what is to come when the general public has access to your product. Keep in mind that even if you get a fantastic response from your beta testers, it is still going to take time for your idea to become well known. Some businesses have fantastic products, but are not discovered until many months later. This is where marketing comes in, but we will get to that in a later chapter of the book. For now, focus on being patient so long as you are in the early stages of your business development. test your ideas as much as you can, and make sure that you are charting all of the responses that you receive. When you take a look at the data, you should be able to pick up on any patterns that are starting to develop. This is valuable to any future business owner because it gives you an idea of what you can expect. There may be problems that arise during these trial runs, but this is exactly what this time is for: correcting issues that you spot now instead of after your launch. While nobody likes to see their idea struggling, it is a lot better to address any issues in the preliminary stages rather than trying to fix them after your business has been officially launched. This is a lot of work to be done, but you are going to thrive if you truly have a passion for your business idea. Try not to become discouraged, because all great things take time. If you are starting to lose steam, read about other businesses and business owners that started from your starting point. Nobody goes straight to the top. When you read about others who have struggled or experienced some of the same hardships that you have, this will give you a boost in confidence. You will see that everyone is going to encounter some type of adversity when they attempt to open a business, but not everyone is going to thrive. There are certain skills and traits that set the successful ones apart. Your goal is to become one of the passionate and resilient individuals. Think about how others will feel when they read about your success story in the future. Chapter 2: Brick and Mortar versus E-commerce. There is a very big distinction that you must consider before you start a new business. Do you want to open a physical location? Do you want to serve your customers online? Or do you want to achieve both? Depending on which approach you choose, this is going to determine the kind of work that must be put into your business idea going forward. At this stage, you should have your plan that is well developed and tested. There should be a feeling of confidence behind the idea that you have now been working with for some time. Now, we are going to discuss the various pros and cons of each option, depending on where you live, what your business aims to accomplish, and the given response from your potential clients. You should be able to gauge which path is going to be right for you. Remember, just because you choose to go solely online for now does not mean you cannot open a physical location in the future. It also means vice versa. Open a store first, then create an e-commerce option for your customers. As you read about each option, make sure that you are considering your budget, available time, and other practical factors that go into making the decision. You may want to do it all, but you already know that diving in right away is not always going to be the best approach. You can still have it all, even if you choose to do one thing at a time. Being a business owner tests your ability to gauge risk factors. The more that you must make decisions for your business, the clearer it will become as to how comfortable you are with taking risks. While this is somewhat of a personal decision that you must make as a business owner, it is also something that you must be reasonable about. If you are willing and able to take risks while still maintaining a backup plan, then this is probably something that will help your business grow. However, if you have no backup plan, then you are probably going to fail. It tends to be pretty black and white when it comes to risk factors, so you must think logically about this. Keeping this in mind, make sure that you are applying each pro and con to your situation and not your ideal situation. Brick and mortar. A brick and mortar business is simply one that operates from a physical location. You will have a storefront set up for your customers to shop. No matter if you are selling a product or offering a service, they will be able to meet with you in person to do business with you. Pros. Your customers will always know where to find you. Your customers will always know where to find you. You can present your product or service in an aesthetically pleasing manner. You will build a rapport within the community. Cons. Upkeep can become expensive: rent, utilities, and/or stocking fees. The pandemic may impact your business operations. You can only sell to those who come inside of your store. When you open a brick and mortar shop, a lot of financial planning is necessary. You are going to have expenses such as a rent payment, utility bills, and any other upkeep related costs. You will also need to make sure that your products are currently in stock. Many people enjoy owning a brick and mortar, even despite these costs. Owning a physical business gives you a chance to become a part of the community. Customers will become familiar with you through word of mouth, which can become a very lucrative marketing strategy. E-commerce. Nowadays, many business owners are opting for an e-commerce setup because it is quicker and more convenient given the social climate. It is faster to get off the ground, and you can essentially work from anywhere that has an internet connection. Pros: you can get started quickly. You do not have to worry so much about keeping products in stock if you use a third-party site to help you. Anyone in the world can find your website and purchase from you. Cons: if you use a third-party website, they are going to take fees out of your sales. You will not be making as big of a mark on your local community. There is a lot of competition. With its rise in popularity, e-commerce setups seem very convenient. They can be if you do your research. A lot of studying is involved when you want to set up an e-commerce style business because you have to make sure that you stand out from the competition, even more than you would if you opened a brick and mortar. A lot of business owners start out online, eventually moving to a physical location if they see that there is a demand for your product or service. It is a flexible option which can fare well for you. A combination. Maybe you are feeling ambitious and you want to opt for both a physical location and a digital location. This is great, and many others feel the same way. After seeing the advantages of both, it is no wonder that you would like to strive for the same goals. Pros: you get the best of both worlds, in person and online. There is more potential for successful sales. Your outreach will be very broad. Cons: since you will be juggling two formats, this means twice as much work. The expenses can add up. If you are not successful, you do not have anything to fall back on. Going for the combination right out of the gate may not be the best move for a first-time business owner. But the great news is that you do not have to launch your business and your website at the same time. There is a chance for you to do both. Once you see one that is working successfully, you can turn your focus on the other. Make sure that you have at least one sustainable option to make things easier on you as you get started. Chapter 3: How to Finance Your Business. Money makes the world go around, no matter how much you detest it. You need a budget that is sensible and logical if you want to see success when you open your business. Obtaining these funds can often be the most overwhelming part of the entire process. When you know that you have a great idea in development, wondering how you are going to make this happen and how you will afford it can often be the source of a lot of anxiety. The following are some great tips for getting funding that not only work, but are realistic. Factoring. This is a method to get financing for your business by selling your receivables at a discount. By doing so, you will be able to get cash up front. Many different businesses use this method, especially those who sell products that must be in stock well before the customers start making purchases. Clothing manufacturers are an example of this type of business. When a customer wants to purchase a shirt, it needs to be in stock or they will be waiting for a long time to get their order fulfilled. When you use this method, keep in mind that it can get expensive. By selling receivables, you must pay a fee that is made up of a percentage of a total amount. For example, you may have to pay a 2% fee that will get you funds for up to 30 days in advance. While this sounds like a great deal, you need to consider that this means you have an interest rate that is the equivalent to around 24%. It can add up fast. Bank loan. This is a fairly standard method to obtain funding if you have good credit. Business owners far and wide rely on loans to get started. Ideally, your business should take off, giving you enough money to not only make a living, but to pay off the loan. With an ideal situation, you must also consider the downsides. Loan APR rates can get expensive, especially when you are not well established yet. The fees that you owe may end up putting you in the red. Before you take out a loan, speak to your local business banker to make sure that this is the right move. Getting advice on the topic of finance is never a bad thing, and it can keep you from making any costly mistakes. Credit card. You probably already have a credit card that comes equipped with a high limit. This is a way to get funding instantly, but similar rules apply to the method above. Your interest rate can end up setting you back if you do not pay off your credit card in a timely manner. All of these expenses and fees add up, even if they seem small at the moment. You need to do some forward thinking before making this decision. There are special credit cards that are meant for business owners, and to get one, you need to open a business bank account. It is definitely worth looking into making sure that you have your budget all planned out beforehand. Always give yourself some room when you make your budget. Include funding for unexpected expenses because they always seem to pop up no matter what type of business you are trying to open. Crowdfunding. In today's world, almost everybody has access to the internet. Movements can go viral overnight. And crowdfunding relies on word of mouth in a different type of way. By starting a crowdfunding page, you are pitching to your audience and trying to convince them to donate to the cause. This method is great because you do not have to pay it back. The only fees you may have to consider are those that you will owe the third-party crowdfunding site. Usually, the cut that they take is not a lot. This is a great method to try, but it requires a lot of traction. You will have to work hard at marketing your campaign, and this may get in the way of your other duties at the moment. If you feel that you want to go this route, but do not have time, you can always hire a campaign manager that will do their best to get the crowdfunding started and keep the momentum going. Pledge future earnings. This is considered a higher risk attempt at funding, but it has worked out well for those who are ambitious and passionate about their causes. To pledge your future earnings, you are stating to your audience that you plan on doing something like making a donation or funding another small business with funds that you have yet to make. There are websites that you can join that will help you structure these options. Of course, it is risky because you do not know exactly how much money you will make and how quickly you will make it. If you pledge 3% of your future earnings by a certain date, then you will have to follow through on this. It will be successful if your business is successful, but there is a big chance that you still might be trying to get off the ground. Be cautious when selecting this method. Partner with an angel investor. An angel investor is someone who aims to help small businesses get started. This is essentially what you would end up doing in the future if the above pledging method worked out for you. To attract any investor, you need to have a pitch already prepared. This pitch should be simple and to the point, but it also needs to detail the hows and whys, make sure that your vision is clear and that you have a great story behind your business. When you pitch to an investor, it is like an audition. You must tell them why you are deserving of this funding and what sets your business apart. During your pitch, you must always be aware of all of your numbers and data. Even if you have yet to make a sale, using projections is essential because your future investor needs to know exactly what they are getting themselves into. Rely on family and friends. It may feel wrong to seek financial help from your friends and loved ones, but this is more common than you may think. In the small business world, many future business owners will pitch their idea to their loved ones in the same way that you would to an investor. You never know who is going to be willing to chip in to see that your dream becomes a reality. The biggest setback here is that you will have to put your pride aside and ask for some very direct help. When you rely on your family and friends to help you reach your financial goals, make sure that you are not going to guilt trip yourself over it later. If someone cares enough and is willing to help out, this is no different than accepting a crowdfunding donation. Give it a try. You may end up being able to get started a lot sooner than you think, thanks to the support of those closest to you. Even if you are receiving help from someone close to you, a good piece of advice is that you create a contract stating exactly how much money is being given to you and whether or not you are expected to pay it back. This will keep things from getting complicated in the future. You can create a structured payment plan with a return date included that you will both sign. This not only provides them with security, but it also keeps you organized in the long run. Chapter 4, Building a Successful Team. Once you have reached this point, you can give yourself credit. You have a business that is achieving milestones. When you have a need to hire employees, this is typically a good sign because it shows that there is a lot more work to be done. Instead of thinking about this and allowing it to overwhelm you, turn this into something positive that you can feel proud of. It has not been easy getting to this point, but now you are going to make even more essential decisions that will ultimately make your life easier. With an excellent team to back you up, you will have a sense of security and stability. The best part of this stage in your business is that you get to handpick your employees from the start. Since you know about your daily operations and future goals best, you should be able to start the interviewing process. Keeping both of these things in mind, you must be able to find people who are willing to work toward these things as if they were running the business themselves. This is how you find passionate employees that will not let you down. As you get started, remember that you never have to settle when it comes to the hiring process. You know what is best for the business, and you can also use your instincts to lead you to the right decisions. It can be scary to let another individual become a part of something you have worked so hard to create, let alone a team of individuals. Since you are in control, you need to work carefully. In this chapter, you will learn some of the very best methods of finding employees that are both suitable and that you can see growth with. You must consider both the present and the future during the hiring process. As you meet each individual, make sure that they have a clear understanding of what they can expect once they are hired and what you plan on accomplishing in the future. This is ultimately the best way to ensure that you are making the right hiring decisions. Doing this yourself makes you a part of your own HR team. It can feel out of your element at first, but your confidence will grow during the process. Practical first steps. Before you put out a help wanted ad, you need to make sure that everything is taken care of on your end. This means that your business must be at a stage where it can begin hiring. Part of this becomes a process where you must be efficient and detail-oriented. If you do not have these elements in place, then you are not going to be successful when you set out to hire your employees. Starting from the very beginning, you need to make sure that you have an EIN, Employer Identification Number, or have applied for one already. This is going to set you up correctly for tax-related matters. Not only is this a necessary step for your business, but it also becomes a way to prove your credibility to those you interview. You can apply on your local government's website. During this process, you should also find out more about the need to obtain state or local tax IDs. There are certain circumstances that you will not need to do this, but for the most part, small business owners almost always need to obtain them if they plan on hiring and paying employees. The next step is to decide if you'd like to hire a W-2 employee or an independent contractor. If you start a business that offers a service, such as a landscaping company, hiring an independent contractor can benefit you because you will save money. They will likely have their own equipment, license, and insurance. All expenses that you will not have to worry about if you had hired them as a traditional employee. Of course, this route is not always going to make sense for all businesses. Most people choose to hire W-2 employees because you have more control of your staff and they will remain loyal to your business. Assuming that you do end up hiring someone, you need to have all of the proper forms ready. This includes the W-4 form, which is a tax form that allows employees to select their withholdings. You must also create your own job application for your employees to fill out, stating their basic information and detailing the job description. This is something that you will both sign in agreement. Not only will this make the job clear to future employees, but it will also prevent you from being sued or accused of not fully explaining all of the requirements. In business, getting everything in writing is essential. Keeping in mind that your team can build up pretty quickly, make sure that you know what your pay periods are going to be. This aspect has a lot to do with what you personally feel you want to do. Will you pay weekly or bi-monthly? Will you pay hourly or salary? To determine these elements, you need to consider how much of your profits will be delegated to the payroll. Make sure that you also create a clear plan for your employees that details any holidays, time off, and vacation days. This can be included in the job description and should specify if you are going to pay for days such as these. Do you plan on managing the payroll, or do you want to hire someone else to do this? It is another decision that you must make that will ultimately make a difference to your own schedule. Managing a payroll in the beginning is likely to be easy, but consider how it will feel in the future. When you have a handful of employees and your own deadlines to reach, will you really be able to crunch numbers as well? No matter who manages the payroll, make sure that everything is being properly documented along the way. This is going to keep you organized and your business steadily growing. From doing research, you must determine how long you need to keep your records on file and when you need to report your payroll taxes of the business to the IRS. Most businesses do this quarterly and annually. To find out the right option for you, contact your local government and small business association. There are many important deadlines that can fluctuate depending on where you live. Never assume that the guidelines are the same for everyone. It is always best to get your own confirmation so you know what you are doing. The interviewing process. Think about job interviews that you've had in the past. What makes for a great interview? There were probably some that lasted way longer or way shorter than you imagine. You have also probably experienced some that just did not seem thorough enough. As a business owner, you want to make sure that your interviewing process covers a list of elements. At the same time, you do not want to come across as too inquisitive and difficult to talk to. Successfully interviewing someone takes skill, and you will fine-tune this skill as you gain your own experience with it. These are some tips you can follow to make sure that you are selecting the best people for the job. Understand what you need. Before you sit down in a room with the candidate, you need to understand exactly what it is that you are looking for. Do you want someone you can train? Do you need to hire someone with experience? These are questions that will guide you in the right direction. If you see potential in someone, but they do not meet your requirements, how much are you willing to take your chances on them? Explain the process. Before you start the interview, explain to the candidate what it is you are looking for and why. Telling them about the business and its mission statement is usually a good icebreaker. You can also ask them if they feel that they can fulfill this role. An indicator of someone that is motivated is their willingness to back your cause. You need employees that are going to be on the same page as you, not just lingering for a paycheck. Spend time with their resume. Before you meet each potential candidate, make sure that you do your own research on them. You should have their resume in your hand before the interview, so make sure that you read each one. This is going to save you time during the interview and allow you to bring up relevant talking points. Plus, an employee appreciates when an employer takes the time to get to know them. This makes the experience personalized. Create a conversation. Have you ever been through an interview that felt more like an interrogation? This is exactly what you need to avoid. Try to make the process feel like a conversation. It can still be a serious interview without having the stiffness of the typical interview. When you truly have a goal of getting to know the person in mind, you will both have an easier time talking to one another. Be transparent with them as well. You can briefly explain your story and how you got started. People are going to want to hear about why your business means so much to you. Listen actively. When the person is talking, make sure that you are actively listening. This extends beyond listening and then nodding for confirmation. You want to make sure that you ask follow-up questions or repeat their answer back in response. This shows that you are being attentive and absorbing what they are saying to you. A good indicator is when the person begins to mirror this behavior. It will show they are engaged and paying attention during the interview. This is a great quality to look for in anyone you hire because attention to detail is important for all businesses. Answer questions at the end. Once you have asked all of your questions, keep an interview going by offering the individual a chance to ask you some questions. This is going to clear up any confusion early on. When you are open to answering these questions during the interview, this will encourage your future employees to come to you with questions later on, an essential part of having a great employer-employee relationship. Overall, the most important things to remember are to be personable and to have a clear idea of what you are looking for. When you combine all of the above tips, you will be sure to lead the best interviews possible. The better the interviews, the more comfortable people will be to show you their true colors. This is what you need when hiring an employee because you need to make sure they are a great fit for your business, not only in the present, but also in the future. Becoming an active leader. Congratulations. You have a team in place that is ready to get the job done. Now you are given the additional task of becoming a leader. As a team leader, you are going to be handed several new responsibilities. While this may challenge you at first, it is bound to be something fulfilling. Your team is counting on you to lead them, but they are also going to be willing to work hard for you to achieve the goals that you have set for them. It should be a mutual relationship that functions based on excellent communication, clarity, and goal setting. To become a truly great leader, you need to make sure that you are an active leader. Below are some tips to help make your dreams of being a great leader a reality. Lead by example. It is easy to tell people what to do all day, but this means nothing if you are not setting a proper example. Your team is going to benefit from seeing you do your very best because this will give them a live role model of the skills that you expect to see from them. As you complete your tasks, make sure you remember that your team is watching you. Embrace failure. Everybody is going to make mistakes. This is simply human nature. When this happens to your employees, you can use the experience in a constructive way. Instead of resorting to punishment or negative reinforcement, make sure that you work with them. Ask them where they went wrong and how they will better prepare for a similar situation in the future. Each mistake can become a learning experience. Be transparent. Your employees need to know what to expect from you. If you maintain a position of being an elusive individual, this is not going to facilitate much trust between you. Being transparent is always the better option. Plus, it will allow your employees to get to know you better. Make time. You need to be available to help others and to answer questions. As you are leading your team, make sure that you are making time for them. A great team is useless if there are team members falling behind. You need to be sure that everyone is always on the same page. Make it a priority to reach out to your team members often. Ask them if they need any help or clarity. Set realistic goals. You already know this about your personal goals, but the same method applies when you are a leader. Your goals need to be realistic. Nobody likes failure. And failure is what you will meet if you set goals that you know are not very realistic. Set your team up for success, and they will be motivated by this accomplishment. The more success they experience, the more they will crave it. Find effective solutions. When you begin working as a team, rather than by yourself, you are going to notice different problems or issues that arise. As an active leader, you need to address these things right away. Even if you do not have an effective solution immediately, you still need to address the issue and let your team know that you are working on it. Connect with one another. Keeping your business life and personal life separate is a smart move to make, but this does not mean that you should not get to know your employees while you are in the workplace. Everybody is unique with different skills to offer. The more that you work together, the more that you should be getting to know one another. Approach everybody in a personable manner, and you will experience the same in return. This will keep your work environment positive and open. Encourage growth. When you start to see who is strongest at what, you can then become motivational. Encourage growth when you see the potential. This is going to give your team a necessary boost in confidence after you express how much you believe in them. They should start to see the potential in themselves. Recognize success. If someone does something great, let them know. This is one of the easiest ways to establish positive reinforcement in the workplace. and it does not take up any of your time. Paying a simple compliment to your team members can go a long way for the overall morale in the workplace. As you do your best to combine all of these traits, you will begin your journey as an active leader. It is a journey because it is something that does not necessarily have an endpoint in sight. You should always be working on your active leadership skills. As you lead more team members, you are bound to learn more about how to become the best leader you can be. It is a period of personal growth for you as a business professional, and it can showcase a lot of your strengths. Make sure that you take the time to recognize what kind of leader you are, and always ask yourself what you can do to become an even better one. Conclusion. After reading through each of the topics presented in this book, you should have a good idea of what you have already done and what still needs to be done. Becoming a business owner puts you in a position where you will realize that constant growth is necessary. If you want your business to grow and to succeed, you must also be willing to grow personally. By expanding your skills, ideas, and methods, you will be able to handle anything that comes your way. Part of this whole process has a lot to do with the confidence you carry. When reading through all of these topics, try to envision yourself in each role. Tell yourself that you can do this and celebrate the successes you experience along the way. Your great idea is going to get you far. This is essential when you are starting any type of business. As you continue to work with your idea, make sure that it is well developed and brought to its final form before you start making concrete business decisions. An idea that has a plan attached to it will take off a lot faster than an idea that is still in its brainstorming stage. If you are still working through the brainstorming stage, never worry, you will get through it, and it is something that you should not rush. Aside from developing your idea, you must also keep in mind that there are several practicalities to take into consideration. How will you get the proper funding? Are you going to open a store or start this business online? Will you hire a team to help you along the way? All of these details can be listed in your business plan. Make sure that you update it often, adding key information that you discover along the way. As you get started with your business up and running, you are probably going to run into challenges along the way. This is normal for any business owner, and it builds character. If you are never faced with any adversity, then how will you truly be able to lead a team through it in the future? Think of any experiences that you encounter as a business owner as a weakness that you can turn into a strength. By observing what happened and why it happened, ask yourself what you could have done differently. Certain things will be outside of your control, like how your given market is going to fluctuate. In cases like these, you must be willing to accept that there will be some things that you just cannot change. Instead of fixating on these things, focus on what you have control of. Do your best to make sure that your skills are strong in these areas instead of wishing that you could change an entire system or group of people. As a business owner, you will need this flexibility if you want to be able to stay on the right path. Along with all of the practical things that you must think about, you also need to make sure that you do not lose yourself along the way. Your business matters to you for personal reasons, and it is okay to think about these aspects as your own motivational factor. When you lose sight of why you are doing this and why you started this business in the first place, it is only going to feel like work. Focusing on what matters to you and what motivates you will keep everything going. It will also keep you true to yourself and true to the vision that you see for the future of the business. It is encouraged that you take a look at the success stories of those in your field or those with similar beginning circumstances. By reading these real accounts of what it was like to get a business up and running, you should be able to put yourself in their shoes. Take inspiration from the experience of others and use the lessons that they talk about during your own journey. Nobody is going to have the exact same experience as you, but there are always going to be people out there who can relate to what you are going through. Pretty soon, you will be a real-life success story that others will be reading about. Make sure that you acknowledge how far you have come. Even since reading this book, you have made a lot of progress toward your overall goal of running a successful business. Give yourself credit where it is due, and make sure that you feel okay with saying that you are proud of yourself. Taking pride in what you do when you are striving for a great cause is a healthy and necessary behavior to master. As times get harder and the challenges begin piling on, you can look back on these moments of pride to get you to the next step. No matter what happens, believe in yourself and in your business. You have an abundance of information to work with now, so use it to your advantage, regardless of which stage you are on. And how developed your business is right now, you are going to become successful and be able to maintain this success. When you feel like giving up, circle back to the main goal that you have in mind and where this idea stemmed from in the first place. By going back to these roots, you should be able to get back on track to becoming the best business owner that you can be. This has been Starting a Business for Beginners and Dummies. Written by Giovanni Richters. Read by Daniel Riccio. Copyright 2021 by Giovanni Richters. Production copyright by Giovanni Richters.